Switzerland versus Wales is a match that I'm very excited about because they both have quite similar teams and we don't know what can happen. The game can go any way. In FIFA World Ranking, Wales is at 17th position and Switzerland is at 13th position. So talking about similarities between the two teams, they both had one of their best performances in Euro 2016, in which Wales managed to reach the semi-finals, in which they lost against Portugal, and Switzerland managed to reach round of 16. Talking about Switzerland, they did not have a very successful campaign in 2020, but in 2021, they have won all the 5 matches that they have had. But the thing is that they did not really have any matches with the top level team. So we are yet to see that what Switzerland will do in this fixture. Xhaka is going to be the leader and he's going to bring experience to the team, whereas Shaqiri is going to have more of a creative role. Well, talking about Shaqiri, he's on the 7th number on the top goal scorers for Swiss. So he has had 23 goals for Switzerland. And it's competitions like these where Shaqiri would thrive. The best thing with Switzerland is that they have an injury-free squad. All the players are fit and fine. And there's a possibility that they're going to do very well in this match. Now, talking about Wales, they have the Spurs forward Gareth Bale, who's going to be the leader. And fun fact is that Gareth Bale is the leading top scorer for Wales with 33 goals. Now, the concern with Wales is that they're not able to get goals. In these friendlies that they had recently, they lost from France by 3-0 and there was a goalless draw against Albania. Now, talking about Wales and Switzerland, they have had 5 matches before this match that they're going to have today, in which Wales has managed to win only twice, and that too, the last match that they had together was in 2011, which Wales won by 2-0. Now, talking about the squad, there was a little bit concern of Aaron Ramsey's injury and even Daniel James, but seems like they will be back today to play the match. Well, I'm here to do my prediction and I'm going to go for Switzerland. I think Switzerland will win this, even though my last prediction with Italy and Turkey was super bad. But here I feel that it's Switzerland who's going to win this match by 2-0. Now let's meet at halftime. Who would have thought that this would be another first half goalless match? The scoreline is 0-0 with better chance from Switzerland. Switzerland's formation is 3-4-1-2, whereas Wales' formation is 4-1-4-1. So we can definitely see that is working in the favor of Switzerland because they came here to win the match. That's why it's 3-4-1-2. They want to win this game and we can see that they have a lot of possession. They are attacking and they are defending very well. But same is the case with Wales. They are defending very, very well. Be it the goalkeeper Wads or the defenders Roberts and Ben Davis, they are actually defending very well and not giving Switzerland any chance to get a goal. It's Switzerland's formation and their gameplay that is more concentrated at midfield, and they are more offensive minded as of now. They are playing with full attack, and oh my god, Seferovic has missed such good chances, and he's the one who has got best of the chances as of now. You know, a clear, complete number 9. Doesn't matter how many defenders are defending him or pressing him, but he is trying his best to get a goal, and his attempts are not too far from getting converted into a goal, and we can see that happening in second half. I have a feeling that Seferovic is going to get a goal because come on, you can't test a man so much. He has been trying so hard to get a goal and all the attempts that he has tried are pretty good, just could not convert it. And Shaqiri using his creativity to distribute the ball to keep the possession intact, and after seeing him I was just feeling one thing, that why don't we make him play so much? I mean, at Liverpool, I wish we could use Shaqiri because he has so much potential. And if there is anybody that has to leave this transfer window, I wish it's not Shaqiri, and I wish Jurgen Klopp uses him more and more in next of the matches that we have in next season, whatever, whenever that comes. I really want to see Shaqiri because whenever he played for Liverpool, he made a significant difference, and clearly he's doing that here too. So in a way, the whole pressing of Switzerland is giving them a lot of ball, a lot of possession and a lot of chances. Imagine they got almost 7 to 8 corners. Switzerland got that many corners but could not convert any. I think having 8 corners and converting at least one, because these days set pieces make a lot of difference, much more than you building up the play and getting a goal. They make a lot of difference. Switzerland's team is looking more threatening, be it Fabian Scher or Mbabu or Xhaka, Shaqiri, everybody. They look really threatening. They just need patience and definitely they can get a goal in second half. The same way it happened with Italy versus Turkey. So they just need to be patient and they can get a goal. And now talking about Wales, they don't have a lot of possession. That does not matter because they're defending very well. Very well they're defending, because in next half also, Switzerland is going to test their patience in defending. That is going to happen. So any chances that Wales is getting is through counter attacks or corners or free kicks that they are getting, and which are not many, but whatever the chances they are getting are pretty very threatening. So if they can convert those, there's a possibility that they might score first, you know. There is a possibility of that happening. It's a very end-to-end match. That is the beauty of it, because when you don't know what is going to happen and which team is going to win, it becomes so unpredictable. That is when the match is more fun. So yes, this is a very one-to-one match, and if Wales concede first, it'll get difficult for them to win the match. Either they can have more possession in second half to, you know, save themselves from getting a goal from Switzerland. But if not that, then Switzerland is definitely going to try even harder and press even harder, and I don't think that Seferovic is going to sit quietly in second half, because I can see a goal coming from him. Let's see if that happens or not. That is all that happened in first half. Let's see what happens in second half. But yesterday we got 3 goals in second half. Let's see what happens today. It's full time and the scoreline is 1-1. If you did not see this match, I don't know what you were doing, because it was such a good second half. Again, it was an end-to-end match, but Switzerland was a better team than Wales. But Wales, I don't know from where did they found the energy in the last 30-35 minutes that everything started clicking for them. Everything started working out for them that was not happening in the first half at all. You know, it was like Switzerland's game for sure. From the very start, it was Switzerland's game. But as soon as one thing started working for them, and Wales was back in the game. Wales was there to get that 1 point, because they knew that it's a brownie point that they're going to get in this game if they can get 1 point from Switzerland. And for Switzerland, it had to be 3 points. Come on, they had to have those 3 points in this game. They can't lose a game like that. The thing is, Switzerland got satisfied with one goal. You can't do that. You can't get satisfied with just one goal. It is not possible that Wales would not make a comeback or, you know, get a goal, because what they did was they dropped the pace, they dropped the possession, and that is when Wales started looking very threatening. That is when Wales got their goal. You know, I don't understand why did Switzerland had to make a change and get Shaqiri out. I think they just got satisfied with that one goal and they thought that it's enough against Wales. And that was the biggest problem, because Wales has a very good team. The players are very good, very talented player, and you can't expect that they would not click, you know, as soon as you drop that possession. You were playing 3-4-1-2. There was no way that, you know, you could have lost the possession in second half as soon as Wales started, you know, getting more of the possession. There is no way that you could have dropped that. But that's what happened for Switzerland. I was expecting a much better second half from Seferovic, but it did not happen. It seems like he just got lazy in second half after that first goal, and then something switched between Seferovic and Embolo. Embolo was so good in second half when he got that goal. He got many chances after that too, which he could not convert. Embolo's goal was very simple. It was from a corner. That is not the point. The point is the run that he made and the save that Ward did, for which he got that corner. I think that was very good. It had to be the responsibility of the captain. Xhaka had to come up there and, you know, motivate his players to just go ahead and get another goal, and to not be satisfied with that one goal, to keep the pace, to keep that momentum, to get another one, because it was not possible for them to drop the pace and then Wales would not, you know, bring something out of their arsenal. As soon as Wales realized that they have a lot more possession than they had in first half, they had a corner and Moore got a goal for Wales, and that is how it became 1-1. Now, credit where it's due. Danny Ward was brilliant. He actually got this 1 point for his team, for Wales. Danny Ward made such good and timely saves, such stunning saves he made, because had he not done that, there is a chance that Wales could have easily conceded 3 or 4 goals, because Ward was very good. He was so good in that goalkeeping today. And Ben Davis, he was everywhere. He did not lose the momentum throughout the game. He was in and out the best player for me for Wales. And then Daniel James was also good, but then he was substituted, for which even he was surprised. And even I was surprised that why did they substitute Daniel James, because he was actually very good. Daniel James got the 2 free kicks that they got at very crucial position. Anyhow, the game ended in a draw, 1-1. It's clearly a loss for Switzerland, because they had to win this. They were playing the formation, they had the attack, they were the better team, but at the end it always depends on who can click better. And in second half, it was Wales who clicked better, who got a equalizer goal, and that is how the game ended. It was actually a very, very good match, very interesting match. And that is it from me today. Thank you. Bye.